Greetings and salutations, everybody. I'm Andrew from Team Respawn. This has been a very busy week for the channel. So a while back, they announced, by they, I mean Microsoft, announced that the older Halo games are coming to the backwards compatibility program, which in turn, I made a video in response saying the Master Chief Collection is dead. They're never touching on again. You can mark my words, bet the farm on it, all that jazz. And then a little while later after that, they announced that they were going to go back and fix the Master Chief Collection. And so then my response to that was, well, then why the hell did you release the older Halo games to begin with? Anyway, I digress. So they announced this like a couple of months ago that they were going to dive back into the Master Chief Collection and quote-unquote fix it. Granted, I've never had issues with the Master Chief Collection. Honestly, I've been able to get into games just fine ever since they did the last patch after the, you know, the fiasco when it launched. However, today, Sketch posted a massive article talking about how the development is going to be done for fixing the Master Chief Collection. I'll drop a link to it in the description if you want to read along with me. I'm just going to kind of hit the high points here because it's pretty interesting, especially from a nerd perspective. It's pretty cool. So they were saying that last October, the 343 team made a public commitment to Halo fans to update and improve the Master Chief Collection, as well as enhance this title for Xbox One X, which kind of leads me to believe, what exactly are you going to do to enhance it? I mean, all the games run at 1080p, 60fps. So are you going to make the jump to 4K? I'm really not sure what they're going to be doing here. And if they're going to do the jump to 4K, they're going to have to do a lot of re-asset creation, theoretically, because all the assets are so old. So we'll just have to wait and see. So it says, They're talking about how they're going to be very transparent during this project because, you know, they royally screwed it up the first time. So they're saying it's going to be a journey, not a race, blah, blah, blah. A division of labor, they say a small but experienced team here at 343 has taken the charter of supporting many of Halo's legacy titles, with Master Chief Collection currently being their number one priority. There's a wealth of experience and expertise on the team, including engineers, designers, and test leads who are intimately familiar with what's good and not so good with the Master Chief Collection. This team is completely separate from the broader 343 team working on the next Halo FPS title. There's zero overlap or shared resources to ensure that the larger game team can remain laser-focused on the future. We're committed to the necessary resources to do both projects right in terms of rest. And then it says, rest assured, while the MCC is highly, incredibly important to the studio, it is in no way interfering or taking away from the next big thing. So that's kind of good. So you know that, hey, some people are worried, is this going to delay Halo 6 or whatever the next Halo game is going to be? Turns out, no. And I could have thought that, to tell you that. Because I think 343 is huge. I've never been there, but I'm assuming it's huge. And I don't think you need all these people to really fix the Master Chief Collection. So it says, requesting backup is the next point here. As awesome as our Legacy Force team is, the Master Chief Collection update is a big, ambitious project. There's lots of work to be done to addressing bugs, updating old systems, adding visual enhancements, improving playlists, and potentially working in bona fide new features. I like this term, working in some new features. And that leads you to believe, well, what features are really missing from the Master Chief Collection? And I think the most obvious one is Firefight. There's no Firefight from Halo 3 ODST in here. I think that is something that would really feel well at home for people. And really, I think people forget that ODST is in the Master Chief Collection, because when they screwed up the first time, like, oh, well, sorry, we're not fixing it, but here's ODST. It's kind of like, well, shit, you didn't fix it, but you gave me something for free because you just say you didn't fix it. So I guess that's okay. And then people were pissed over a free game, which is not free anymore. I think it's like $5. So it's worth the $5 because it's, you know, Master Chief Collection enhanced. That runs at 1080p 60 as well. And they're like, where's the Firefight? So I think that can make an improvement with the Firefight voices like Sergeant Johnson and things of that sort. I hope that makes it in here, because that's really the only feature I think is really missing from these Halo games. I mean, there's the loadouts from Halo 4. There's Forge mode. There's Theater mode. There's Spartan Ops. So It says we're going to need a little bit of backup. We already have plans to mobilize our community for hands-on testing, but ultimately that model isn't really viable when it comes down to working on development tasks with the code base itself. Kind of like a no shit kind of a deal. To help us achieve these goals, we've tapped some external support to partner with us through this project. We're currently in the process of working through various milestones, like getting processes tools in place, getting familiarized with the many code bases, working through scopes and schedules, and generally getting all the foundation elements locked so there's a clear, realistic plan of attack. So what they're saying is while their small team knows what they're doing, they don't have the amount of manpower to really power through this, which is understandable. You got to take in mind that this is like 8 games in one game here. I mean, it's a massive undertaking. I'd say this is one of the biggest scopes of a remaster / definitive edition / port over of anything ever in video games. I mean, name something that has 2 remasters and 3 ports in it, and all the multiplayer stuff and all that's in it. I mean, it's a huge game. So it's smart for them to do this. And it makes me wonder, like, who are they going to partner with? And it makes me think that, you know, some of the development teams that they worked with at the past, which is not Creative Assembly, the other one where their logo is CA. It's, crap. The name's escaping me now. I can't think of it. And then maybe Saber Interactive. Maybe. I don't know. We'll have to look and see. I'm sure it's someone they worked with in the past. But that's cool. Taking flight together. So this is pretty interesting. This is where they get all nerdy. They're saying they want the community involved with the testing of this. So they're going to release like incremental versions of the new Master Chief Collection. And then a small group of players will test it before it gets pushed out to the wild. So it says, this will be a separate version, in quotes, of the Master Chief Collection that's released for public testing of updates and patches during development. So pretty much you're playing with a different Master Chief Collection than the one that's on your disc. So this is kind of where you would, I guess you compare it to Minecraft, the general one, and then Minecraft Xbox One. Like, they're 2 versions of Minecraft on the Xbox One. Just one's an update and one's the base game, kind of. Like, the Minecraft without the Xbox One at the end, that's the Minecraft that's cross-platform and uses the Bedrock engine that they, talk about so much. So this is kind of cool. I can dig with this, because pretty much what they're saying is they can screw up that version of the Master Chief Collection and not have to worry about messing up the retail version of the Master Chief Collection. And once they get the the bastardized version up and running, then they can push that to the retail disc or download or whatever you have. So that's a smart idea. So it says, currently the thought is that flighting will roll out in incremental stages with larger potential audiences being added with each new update. Initially, we're going to start very small. In fact, the internal team is already has a flight ring set up just for them to test out early updates and get familiarized with the process. So it's kind of cool. The latest test plans we're looking like will kick off in a meaningful way sometime in March, but we'll definitely keep you updated as details are locked. And then it says, like, if you want to be involved, there's links here. So if you want to be involved, there's links there. It's later down in the article. Laying the foundation. So they're talking about these 2 dudes, Greg and Andrew, not me, but some other dude, have been hard at work shoring up Master Chief Collection's foundations and updating out-of-date systems, services, and technologies. These are the legacy team's directors, so I guess they really know their shit when it comes to old stuff. So this is where they get super nerdy. They're talking about all the stuff they're going to do to where you'll get meaningful and noticeable improvements to the Master Chief Collection. I'm going to touch on this just a little bit. So they're saying matchmaking services from Xbox Live have improved immensely since 2014 when the game came out. Let's see. Under the old model, the system software was the authority on who was connected to who and how. And now, the game title itself takes responsibility for that and gets to decide what the party composition is. This gives the title and us a lot more control over party management. Now, talking about the updated APIs that brings many improvements. So you're saying you won't get many notifications saying you got kicked out from a party. You won't be able to join a party. That's going to be a thing of the past. A lot of times you would lose your notifications within the Master Chief Collection. They're saying there's a lot of updates to the API to where that won't be happening anymore. So that's kind of cool. They're saying in order to take advantage of the latest and greatest matchmaking systems, the underlying platform API also needs updating. That means all 8 of the game's engines running in the Master Chief Collection need to go through this update process. That's right, 8 separate engines. Halo 1 Classic, Halo 1 Anniversary, Halo 2 Classic, Halo 2 Anniversary, Halo 3, Halo 3 ODST, Halo 4, and Halo 2 Anniversary Multiplayer. All of those are different engines, and I mean, we all knew that. So essentially, it's 8 games in one is what makes up the Master Chief Collection. So they're saying this simplifies our code around friends and presence management. And foundationally, this update opens up the possibility to other things we like to explore, like custom game session browsing, Xbox Arena, or Mixer support. So that's kind of cool. I thought that was already implemented because that's a OS thing. But maybe you can like browse in the Master Chief Collection for people on Mixer. I don't know. So they're talking about the app model slash reboot. In the original MCC, you have the unified user interface running, and then depending on which game you launched, one of the 8 separate engines would run, and then upon completion, the software would fully reboot. This is one of the underlying challenges of the Master Chief Collection when it came to reconstructing the network session after each discrete reboot. So what does this mean? Here's Greg with an explanation. He says, now instead of doing a reboot of the entire process, we just unload the DLL and cleanly shut down each game engine. This means there's less of a chance your network session of breaking down. You'll also notice a much faster game-to-game transition time, greater overall UI consistency, and it also makes it easier for us to manage multiplayer experiences and get players back into matchmaking quicker after a game session ends. So this is really cool. This is really going to power the UI of Master Chief Collection. You can get in and out of games faster, switch nonsense, do the damn thing. It's pretty nice. They're talking also about peer-to-peer connections. Essentially, they were saying, you know, there's a lot of updates to Xbox Live. They say with the original MCC, peer hosting was used for match-made games as a failback. Or fallback, I can't read that. If dedicated servers weren't available for whatever reason, we're moving to a model where dedicated servers will now be guaranteed for all match-made games, meaning lag should be a thing of the past, usually. That's a very, very good thing, and that's awesome. It says, looking ahead, it says, this is by no means everything that's been done so far, but with this great foundational refresh complete, the team has been able to start on a number of other big-ticket items, including general bug fixing, visual enhancements for Xbox One X, and more. In the coming weeks, we'll be sharing more updates from the trenches of development. In the meantime, if you have any questions, please post them over in the forum, blah, blah, blah. Thank you. Yeah, see you later. So this is really cool. And you never really saw this in the past when they're messing with broken-ass games. Granted, the Master Chief Collection was really the first broken-ass Halo game, and we've kind of had a broken-ass Halo game ever since, so they've really been on a roll here. But it's good that they've realized that the people want this to be fixed. This is a very good thing. I still believe Master Chief Collection is an auto-buy on the Xbox One. If you have an Xbox One, you should have the Master Chief Collection. It's a no-brainer. And it's going to be great when this is done. So we're going to be kind of covering this process here on the channel because I think it's pretty cool. Maybe we'll get involved in some of this community playtesting stuff that they're talking about because I'm in the Xbox Insider program, so I might be able to get my hands on this bastardized Master Chief Collection version. And if I can, if there's not an NDA or anything, I can post some gameplay of the changes so you can see what's coming before it comes out. Post your thoughts in the comments down below. Love to hear what kind of features you want in the Master Chief Collection, because the only thing I can think of is Firefight. But maybe I'm missing something. Anyway, Master Chief Collection's getting fixed. This is awesome. I'm pretty stoked. Thanks for watching. I'm Andrew from Team Respawn. I'll see you later.